Thank you. Thank you. About 4 years ago, I did something that I probably won't do again as a parent. I loaded my family of five, my wife, three children, up in the car, and we drove 13 hours to Florida. Now, the problem with this decision was that the car only seated five people, which means that the children were sitting three across in the back. And parents, some of you know exactly where this is going already. So with them seated so close to each other in the back, it wasn't long before we heard, you know, Mom, Lila hit me, Mom, that was on my side, Mom, we're gonna leave me alone. And it's just, you know, stop fighting, kids, stop. It's fine, we're almost there, we'll make it. But as you know, in a confined space, in the car, no matter how much excitement there was about going to Disney World in 13 hours after we get to Florida, the drive kind of just consumed them, and it was just too difficult in that confined space. And as you know, as a parent, one of the challenges that we have is for our children to get along. We want nothing more for them to get along with each other. Now, by some of you who are wise, you only have one child, you don't have this problem. So, very smart, good forethought. I wish I thought of that. Right? Yeah. So, with three, one of the issues that you will always face if you have two is to have your children get along with each other. And that's our desire as parents, that's our heart's desire. And it's interesting because I believe that's also our Heavenly Father's heart's desire, is that His children would get along with each other. One of the famous passages of this season of the year is when the angels appear to the shepherds and they announce, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace, goodwill toward men." And it is the longing of God for there to be peace on earth. Unfortunately, what we often see when we look around us in the world today is the opposite of that. We see conflict, we see division, we see people bickering, fighting with each other, and we don't see peace on earth. And we wonder, will we ever see peace on earth? And the good news of the Advent season, the season of the first coming of Jesus, is that it also points forward to the second Advent, the second coming of Jesus, when He will restore peace to this earth. And I don't know about you, but I long for that day. However, I also believe that when we allow Jesus to come and live in our hearts, that we will become agents of His peace on earth. And that if we have eyes to see it, we can see that God is already at work in this world in many ways and in many places, promoting peace on earth. And you and I have the wonderful privilege of being used by God to become agents of His peace on this earth, so that wherever we go, we can spread peace on earth this holiday season.
Thank you. Mary, did you?